Man, my blood pressure is crazy. It's high, it's low, it's all over the place, man. What's a boy to do? All right. Let me explain how you check your blood pressure at home. What's up, San Antonio and world? I'm Dr. Qasim Butt, and I'm a kidney doctor, and I'm here to break down health in a simple way. Now do me a favor, hit up that like and share button. It'll really help me out. When you go to the doctor's office, a lot of y'all get nervous, and that level of anxiety can result in something called white coat hypertension, meaning your blood pressure is actually normal, but when you see me, you get anxious and you raise it. The best way to see how your blood pressure is actually doing is to check it at home. But it's kind of critical that you do it in the proper way. And that's what I'm going to go over today. Now, to know exactly what high blood pressure is, y'all got to check out my video on it. What blood pressure monitor to buy? Now, I've seen blood pressure monitors vary in range from anywhere from $20 to over $100. I would opt for the mid-range, around $40 to $50, to get a decent quality. I prefer the monitors that check blood pressure in the upper arm rather than the wrist. They're kind of closer to the heart, so they may get a better accurate reading. Also, if you're tech savvy, I would opt for the ones that are Bluetooth or Wi-Fi enabled. That way they can connect to your phone and record the readings. Now, if you already have one for a few years, you may want to consider getting a new one every 2 to 3 years. You gotta remember, these are just consumer products. They're not hospital grade, so their accuracy can deteriorate. If you want to make sure your blood pressure monitor is actually working correctly, you can bring it to your doctor's office and compare it to their machine. And this should be done probably on an annual basis just to make sure it is actually accurate. How to check your blood pressure. Make sure you are calm and relaxed. If you are taking blood pressure medications, make sure you've taken them on that day. Make sure to avoid caffeine, smoking, or exercise for at least 30 minutes before you check. Sit down on a comfortable chair or sofa with your arm raised level to your heart. Make sure your legs are straight and not crossed. Wait about 3 to 5 minutes. Then take your blood pressure. Then do yourself a favor and make sure to write it down. The top number, the bottom number, and the pulse. You need to keep an accurate log. As far as timing, you should take it twice a day. Once in the morning, once in the evening. But you need to be consistent with your times. So if you take it 10 a.m. on one day, you should take it around 10 a.m. on other days, as blood pressure tends to fluctuate throughout the day. How often to take your blood pressure? If you're trying to diagnose yourself with high blood pressure, meaning you've never had it before, then I would advise taking it twice a day for 7 days straight to get a good idea. If you've had a recent change to your blood pressure medications, I would advise taking it twice a day for 14 days straight to see if that blood pressure medication change is actually working. Now, if you have well-controlled high blood pressure on medications and it's been stable, then I would advise you taking it twice a day, either on a weekly or monthly basis, just to make sure it's staying stable and normal. Make sure to bring those readings, that log, to your doctor's office. That'll get you the best management of your blood pressure. If you found this video helpful, please like and share it. Oh, and if you got something to say, please leave comments in the comment section below. And remember, it's your kidneys, your health.